show. We're getting ready now, come get go. What don't you? Never my blues wait you. You can do anything, but lay off of my blues. You can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place. I do anything that you want to do, but I'm a honey, lay off of my shoes. And don't you? Never my blues wait you. It's one for the month, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, can't go, but don't devil my blues ways. You can do anything for the help of my blues ways. Hey! It's one for the month, two for the show. To get ready now, go, can't go, but don't you devil my blues ways. You can do anything, but they hold my blues ways. It's a blue, blue, a blue ways shoe, got a blue, blue, a blue ways shoe, baby. Blue, blue, a blue ways shoe, uh-huh. Blue, blue, a blue ways. You can do anything, but they hold my blues ways. I said I got a woman way across town. She's good to me. Oh, oh yeah. And I said I got a woman way across town. She's good to me. Oh yeah. I seen my baby. Don't you understand? Grandma's a fusses, this treats me right. Never run in the streets, leaving me alone. She knows a woman's place. Right there, now in a home, I got a woman. Way across town, she's good to me. Oh, I said I got a woman. Way across town, she's good to me. Oh yeah, I see my baby. Don't you understand? She's all right. She's all right. All right. I got a woman way over town. She's good to me. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Again, man. It's like my horse has left. Mm-hmm. Come on, you can do it. Come on. Mm-hmm. That's it. It just tapers off to nothing. Mm-hmm. Oh, well, bless my soul, what's wrong with me? I'm itching like a man on a bug tree. My friends say I'm acting a wild as a bug. I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Uh-huh. Yeah, yeah. Oh, well, my hands are shaky and my knees are weak. I can't seem to stand on my own two feet. Who do you think of when you have such a look of me? I'm all shook up. Yeah, yeah. Well, please don't ask me what's on my mind. I feel screwed up, but I feel fine. When I meet a girl and I love it, my heart is killing me to death. She touch my hand, I want a chill I've got. Her lips are like a volcano that's hot. I'm proud to say that she's my buttercup. I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Yeah, yeah. Oh, please don't ask me what's on my mind. I'm a little bit stubborn, but I feel when I'm near a girl and I love it. My heart beats so it scares me to death as you take my hand. What a chill I got. I look so like a volcano that's hot. I'm proud to say that she's my buttercup. I'm in love. I'm all shook up. Yeah, yeah. Good evening. Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to the big freaky international hotel with these little weirdo dolls on the walls and these little funky angels in the ceiling. This is my first live appearance in 9 years. Whew. Thank you. I've appeared dead a few times, but this is my first live appearance. Before the evening is over, I will have made a complete total fool of myself. And I hope you get a kick out of watching it. Also, I have to go back here during the show and drink a lot of Wawa. It's so dry here in Las Vegas, so singers have something wrong with them. Man, I can't see what I started to say. Singers have what they call a Vegas throat. It's when you get real dry and you feel like Bob Dylan slept in your mouth, you know. Yes, ma'am. Yes, you bet your bird. One of the first records I ever made. Oh, yeah, I got some stuff back here called Gatorade. Stuff is supposed to work like 12 times faster than water, and they give it to athletes and people who sweat a lot. Looks like it's already been used to me, I'll tell you for sure. But if it aids your gator, it's all right. No. One of my first records that I made, I recorded back in 1927, I think it was. More like this.
Love me tender, love me sweet, never let me go. You have made my life complete, and I love you so. Love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Through all the years, till the end of time. Well, in love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will. Tell me you are mine. I'll be yours through all the years, till the end of time. Well, and love me tender, love me true, all my dreams fulfill. For my darling, I love you, and I always will.
I'd like to, every time I put this thing on, man, it's like, you know, I had a hard time in the army and they gave me a rifle. I go, you know. So, and he yelled, "Tench, hut!" I'm going, I'd like to do a medley of some of my biggest records for you. They were actually no bigger than the rest of them. They were all about the same size, but it sounds impressive. When I first started out in the business, I had three pieces, three instruments. Yeah, what's that? Oh, smoke. Going to a party in the county jail. Prison band was there and they began to wail. Man was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard him knock down till bird sail. Everybody, let's rock, 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 rock. Everybody in the whole slam block was the engine of the jailhouse. Out of Murphy played a tenor saxophone.
Forget the past before I kick your ass. Don't be cruel.
Yeah.
to think of a special song for tonight, a message song, you know, something that really says something. This is what I came up with. That's what I came up with. I looked her square in the eye because that's all she had was one big square eye right in the middle of it. I said, baby, she said, She was a little weird too, you know. She had a guitar on. We were both leaned over like this, looking at the floor. So I said, baby? She said, deeper, deeper. I said, baby, baby, you know. So, they're gonna come get me, man, I'll tell you for sure. So I stood there and watched the sweat fall on the floor for a while, you know. And I laughed, and she got mad and left. So I was standing there by myself. So I got up very close in her face. I said, baby, baby. And I jumped off the lily pad into the water, you know, sound like a frog. And I sniggered a while, and the girl was gone. See, I was still standing here looking at the floor by myself, you know, like a stone-cold freak, man. So my legs were getting tired, so I figured I better get on with what I was doing, you know. So I said, baby. She said, Weird chick, man, you know. I said, I got up real close to her, and I said, have you got a lot of hairspray on your hair? She said, yeah, you know. Her voice cracked. She was a freak, you know. And I watched the sweat fall on the floor again, you know. I got up very, very close to her, and I said, fell asleep. You know. You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
I made up my mind. Yes, I did.
Christmas to stay. Yes, it is. So I just live my life in dreams of yesterday. Maybe I'll be with you after the show, wait a minute. I'd like to talk to you a little bit, ladies and gentlemen, about how I got started in this business and when. A lot of things that happened from my side of the story. There's been a lot written about what happened from everybody else's side, but not from my side. So, my nose is running, my eyes are running, my ears are running, everything. Could I have some more? I started out as a child. No, wrong, wrong. Thank you. I started out when I was just out of high school, and I was driving a truck, and I was training to be an electrician, and I got wired the wrong way, baby. That's what happened to me. I was driving a truck one day on my lunch break. I went into a record shop and made a record, you know, just for my own use. I wasn't really trying to get into the business. And the guy put the record out about a year and a half later. And overnight in my hometown, people were saying, you know, who is he? What is he? Is he? You know. And I'm saying, am I? I didn't know. So he got to be pretty big in my hometown. And then it got to be pretty big in certain parts of the country, but nobody really knew who I was, you know. So I started working in little nightclubs and little football fields and little alleys and little weird rooms with little things crawling in the ceiling looking back at you. And I did that for like a year and a half. And then in 1956, I met Colonel Sanders. Parker. So they arranged to put me on television. And at that particular time, there was a lot of controversy because you didn't see people moving too much out in public. Hey, we're getting it on in the back, but out in public you didn't see it too much. So anyway, I went to New York to do this Steve Allen, Jackie Gleason. Boy, just a matter of time, man. The brain goes, the body, everything. The Jackie Gleason show. So I did 3 of the Jackie Gleason shows. You know, I've never been out of my hometown in my life. So I was in New York, clearing my throat, and they said, well, get him out of here, you know. What's that? Oh, smoke. Thought it was a spook, a ghost. So anyhow. Lord have mercy. So anyway, I did the Jackie Gleason show 3 times, and I was in New York. I had sideburns, you know. 14 years ago, it was really weird, you know, walking in the street with sideburns. Harry, get him! What? Now he's a squirrel, man, you know. I'm done. I'm like, people wonder why I shook so much. I was, yeah, you know. So anyway. What was I? Oh, yeah, I did the Jackie Gleason show 3 times, and then I went to the Ed Sullivan show. And Sullivan, you know, the cameras were photographing me from the waist up. And Sullivan standing over there saying, son bitch, you know. So I'm saying, thank you, Ed, thank you. I didn't know what he was calling me at the time, you know. Then I went to, I did 2, 3, or 4 of the Ed Sullivan shows. And then I went to the Steve Allen show. And they were going to tame me down, you know. So they dressed, what's that? Oh, smoke. Oh. They dressed me in a tuxedo, you know, and I'm standing very still. And they told me not to move. And I'm singing to a dog on a stool, you know. I'm saying, you ain't nothing but a hound dog. And the dog's going, So I'm watching the dog, you know. So anyway, the next move was Hollywood. So that goes to the mouth. What was I saying, man? Oh, the next move was Hollywood, yeah. So I went to Hollywood, and I wasn't ready for that town, and they weren't ready for me, you know. So first of all, you get a hit record, and you go on television, and then you go to Hollywood. That's how it happens. So I was out there, and, you know, it was all new to me. I was like 19 or 20 years old, so. It was all exciting, and everybody was saying, hey, Miss President, Miss President, Miss President, you know, Miss President, zombies, you know. I did Love Me Tender and Loving You, Loving Her, Loving Anybody Get My Hands On at the time. My health was failing, my mind was going bad, and, So then I did Jailhouse Rock, and they told me to clean up the act, man, really. Jailhouse Rock, and then I did King Creole. So I'd done 4 pictures, and I was, you know, living it up. I was really getting used to the movie stuff. God, oh, I've been here a long time, man. That looks like Kirk Corcoran coming up through there, you know. Him and Howard Hughes, somebody. Anyway, I was getting used to the movie star bitch, you know. I had dark glasses on, you know, sitting in the back of a Cadillac limousine saying, I'm a movie star, hey, I'm a zombie, hey. So, weird, you know, eating hamburgers and drinking Pepsi Colas. So, I did that, you know, I was living it up, man. And then I got drafted. So, so overnight, it was all gone, man. It was like it was a dream, you know. I was saying, was that me? Did it happen? You know. So all the guys in the service, they just watched me at first to see what I was going to do, you know. They said, what you going to do? I'm sitting around going, trying to play the rifle, you know. And so they just watched me at first to see what I was going to do. And when they saw I was doing the same thing they were, everything was okay, you know. So but the guys in the service must get awfully homesick because they call each other mother a lot. And they... I kind of picked it up, you know. It didn't go over too well back in Hollywood when I got out, you know. I'd go up to some director, how you doing, your mother? You know, get him out of here, man. He's a squirrel. So So I came back to Hollywood in 1960, and oh, it's me. Then I did GI Blues and Blue Hawaii and Girls, 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 which wasn't a picture, just Girls, Girls, Girls. I did Viva Las Vegas, and I did a little 8mm black and white underground film called Up Your Nose. It ain't out yet. It's they're still editing it, you know, cutting out the rough parts. So anyway, the reason I'm telling you this story is I got into a rut, you know, just off of Hollywood Boulevard. I had this big rut. And I was waiting and said, "Help, help, I'm in a rut." And I said, "Stay down there, you fool." So I got into a routine of making pictures, and I was doing one picture after the other. And I was missing. No, whew, God. No, I was missing a contact. Boy, when it happens, it just falls apart. Boy, I'll tell you. I cleared my throat and I tried to regain my composure, you know. So anyway, we got into a routine of making pictures, and I was missing contact with the live audience. So that's why I'm back, and I just want to tell you for myself. So I can play this mother a little bit. See?
Yeah.
lonesome tonight? Do you miss me tonight? Are you sorry we drifted apart? Does your memory stray to a bright summer day, or when I kissed you and called you sweetheart? Do the chairs in your parlor seem empty and bare? Do you gaze at your doorstep and picture me there? Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight? I wonder if you're lonesome tonight. You know, someone said the world's a stage, and each must play a part. Fate had me playing in love with you as my sweetheart. Act one was where we met. You read your lines so cleverly, I never missed a cue. Then came act two. You seemed to change, you acted strange, and why I've never known. Honey, you lied when you said you loved me. I had no cause to doubt you, but I'd rather go on to hearing your lines than to go on living without you. And the stage is bare, and I'm standing there with emptiness all around. And if you won't come back to me, then they can bring the curtain down. Is your heart filled with pain? Shall I come back again? Tell me, dear, are you lonesome tonight?
Only words, and words are all I have to
yesterday. All my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Suddenly, I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow hanging over me. Oh, yesterday came suddenly. Why she had to go, I don't know. She wouldn't say. I said something wrong. Now I long for yesterday. Yesterday, love was such an easy game to play. Hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Why she had to go, I don't know. She wouldn't say. I said something wrong. I long for yesterday. Yesterday, love was such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Show off. Before I do anything else, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to straighten out my thing here. I'd like to introduce, hello Larry. I'd like to introduce the members of my band. Charlie, this is Jerry. James. The members of my crew that are doing such a fantastic job for me. First of all, the young ladies that open us. Can I lay it on you so you sit down? Show.
Thank Thank you.
Remember? First of all, young ladies that opened our show tonight. They really live up to their name, ladies and gentlemen, the Sweet Inspirations. And, beautiful quartet voices you hear in the black back belong to the great Imperials, ladies and gentlemen. young man on lead guitar, he's one of the finest guitar players I've ever met. His name is Chuck Berry. His name is James Burton, ladies and gentlemen. Young man on rhythm, he makes records for RCA. His name is John Wilkinson. His father makes blades. young man on drums, he's from Dallas, Big D. His name is Ronnie Tutt. Young man on the Fender bass, his name is Jerry Schiff. So he's Tut and he's Schiff. That's Tut Schiff any way you look at it, I'll tell you for sure. the young man on piano and organ, ladies and gentlemen, his name is Larry Mahovarak. Yeah, Larry. Mahovarak. 1969 Mahovarak. the guy that hands me my water and guitar and stuff, he's a good friend of mine. I met him when I was in the Army. His name is Wooly Booger. Now, Charlie Hodge. Charlie. Orchestra. Lord, have mercy on them children. just blew the whole thing, man. I just lost control completely. Our orchestra conductor, ladies and gentlemen, he's a heck of a nice fellow. His name is Bobby Morris. Bobby? Yeah. I can say hello to the Bobby Morris Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah, the Wooly Booger. Did I leave anything out? If it is, I'm just going to leave it out. Let me ask some of that stuff, man. Gatorade. It goes down in my leg, you know, like fuel, fuel. A record, it just did very well for me recently, ladies and gentlemen.
As a snow flies on an old and gray Chicago morning, a poor little baby child is born in the ghetto. And his mama cries, if there's one thing that she don't need, it's another hungry mouth to feed in the ghetto.
In the ghetto.
Now people, don't you understand? Johnny's a helping hand. He's gonna be an angry young man someday. I take a look at you and me. Are we too blind to see? Or do we simply turn our heads and look the other way? Will the world turn and a hungry little boy with a runny nose plays in the street as a cold wind blows in the ghetto.
In the ghetto.
And his hunger burns, so he starts to roam the streets at night, and he learns how to steal, and he learns how to fight in the ghetto. Desperation, the young man breaks away. He buys a gun, he steals a car, he tries to run, but he don't get far, and his mama cries. As a crowd gathers round, an angry young man face down in the street with a gun in his hand in the ghetto.
In the ghetto.
And as her young man dies, on a cold and gray Chicago morning, another little baby child is born in the ghetto.
In the ghetto.
And his mama cries.
In the ghetto.
Let me change this thing while I'm over here, man. Wait a minute. A new record, ladies and gentlemen, that I have recorded. It should be in the record shop here tomorrow. I just found out. Plug. Garwood Van's Record Shop. It's a new record that I just recorded. I hope you like it. It's called Suspicious Mind. Let's get it on.
We're caught in a trap. I can't walk out because I love you too much, baby. Why can't you see what you're doing to me? When you don't believe a word I'm saying, we can't go on together. The suspicious mind. And we can build our dreams on suspicious minds. So if an old friend I know stops by to say hello, would I still see suspicion in your eyes? Here we go again.
Too much, baby.
too much, baby. Check all my sore spots. You're a beautiful audience, ladies and gentlemen. I can do this. You're really beautiful, thank you. I can do this song especially for you.
Wise men say only fools rush. But I can't help falling in love with you. Shall I stay? Would it be a sin? To be